We have to prepare the master specimen as a part of the mix design. So first of all, before I proceed further, I want to tell you this blend of aggregate is with me, and I have prepared this blend of aggregate, and all these three blend of aggregate, they are having the same weight, and I have taken it as 1275 grams for the blend of the aggregate. 1275 grams for the blend of the aggregate, and these are shown over here. So some people are using 1200, some people are using 1250, but I have used 1275 grams for the development, and these three are shown over here. And bitumen content, as I have already told you, I will vary by 2.5%, 3%, 3.5%, 4%, 4.5%, and 5%. For every of these, each of this will be having the same weight, 1275 grams. Here I will take three samples. Every one will be 1275. And so on. As I have shown you over here, I will keep this 1275 weight constant. Next, now I want to tell you how we will calculate the amount of bitumen content in order to make the mix. So this calculation is very simple. If you have understood this one, bitumen content or asphalt content can be written as, how much weight I have assumed, 1275. If I take bitumen content 2.5%, then out of 100 remaining all will be my aggregate, it means 97.5% will be my aggregate. When I multiply these two quantity, I will get 32.7 grams. This is my asphalt content in grams. This is my weight of aggregate in gram. How much will be my total mix? Total mix will be 1275 plus 32.7, 1307.7 gram. It is my weight of total mix. This is a procedure that we will go on changing the bitumen content accordingly. The percentage of aggregate will change, and we will go on getting the different value, and in this way we will go on getting the total weight of the mix. But myself, here for my practical demonstration, I want to determine the amount of asphalt content over the same, but here my bitumen content is 3.5 and remaining will be 46.2 gram. When this 46.2 gram will be added into this one, it will give my total mix. My total mix will be 1275 plus 46.2, 1321.2 grams. This is my total weight of the mix. So it means
in each of these by three blended aggregate, I will add 46 gram of the bitumen content and I will mix it very well.
Then it will be 1341.2 gram. So keep this in mind. This is a very fundamental calculation which is required in order to make the total weight of the mix. Other important thing, before we proceed further for the mix design, we will have to know the relationship between viscosity and temperature. It's very, very important. So you can write down viscosity temperature relationship. Viscosity temperature relationship. Viscosity temperature, but in MS2, which is a guide for the development of the mix sign. Here the reference point is given 170 plus minus 20 CST. CST is the unit of viscosity. Okay. If we have this viscosity, whatever the temperature will come within this viscosity, it will be used. Mixing procedure. After mixing procedure, we have to compact it. For the compaction, we will need 280 plus minus 30 CST. So, rather than, I will show you graph over here. I have already plotted this graph. This graph is shown over here. You see, this is my temperature. And this is my viscosity value. Viscosity is dipping downward. It means as the temperature is increasing, viscosity is decreasing. This range, which I have given over here, mixing range, it is having the viscosity given over here, mixing temperature 170 plus minus 20 centistoke. And this is the compaction range, and I have written over here, it is giving this range of temperature, and it is by the 280 plus minus 30 centistoke. So this is my temperature and viscosity relationship, which we have to know by all the means.
Next, now everything is clear to us.
Next, we have to, because this is the Marshall specific procedure of mixed design development by Marshall method. Very fundamental thing. What is the apparatus to be used over here? Now let me introduce it to you. This is my base plate. And over this base plate, I have my dispense weapon, Marshall mold. This mold is having the internal dia 101.6 millimeter. This is the dia of the mold. And height of this mold is 75 millimeter. And over this mold, we have to put another thing at the top. This is known as the loose corner. This is known as the loose corner. This is known as your Marshall mold. And this is known as your base plate. It is placed paper. And over this paper, we are going to place this one. And then we will put the material. This material which we are putting over here, it is the combination of this aggregate and bitumen content. And this is, after adding and mixing it very well, we have to compact it. By Marshall machine. This Marshall machine is mechanically operated and manually operated.
having a damping face, over which it has the sliding weight, and that sliding weight is equal to 4.5 kg. And sliding height or falling distance, you can say that 457 millimeter.
On this understanding, and I have also given you this introduction over this one, our next step. We will take one pen. We will put this material into this one. And after that, we will add bitumen content, yeah, asphalt content into this one. We will mix it very well. When it is mixed, mixing temperature I have already told you, depending upon the viscosity, 170 plus minus 20 centistoke. When it is mixed very well, after that, we will put this material into this Marshall board. And we will take spatula. Along the perimeter, we will tamp it 15 times. This is now another perimeter. We will tamp it 15 times. And 10 times we will tamp it from the center. We will make it at the shape just like this one. We will put one paper over here again. It will be placed under Marshall compaction apparatus. Now I am no more going to explain about the Marshall compaction apparatus, but just that is just introduction by your already told you. Now how many blows are required? So for these blows, there are three ideas: 35, 50, and 75. For the medium traffic, 35 blows. Sorry, for the light traffic, 35 blows. For the medium, 75. Sorry, for the medium, 50. And for the heavy traffic, 75 blows. You will tap it 75 times on each face. If you have done tapping 75 on one face, you will invert it. And again, you will do it 75 on the other face. Then you will take out and leave it. Let it be cooled down itself. After cooling, you will extract it to do further analysis. Now I will show you the practical demonstration that how we are going to mix it, this aggregate and the bitumen in my mixing apparatus. 1276 or 75 gram material is put over here in the mixing board. Now over this material, we will add 46.2 gram of the bitumen content. Now this desired quantity of this bitumen is added into this one. And now the mixing procedure is started. And you will see that this bitumen content is very, very properly mixed with this aggregate. And this mixing process is going on. During the mixing process, you will have to stir it very well, because we are doing the manual mixing, we are not doing the machine mixing. You will see the coating is increasing over the aggregate. There is no single particle which is free from this one. This bitumen is completely coated on the surface of the aggregate, and over after this we will